Nina benkonjani dokele ezulwini ezinye ezidokele emafini ohlelweni lanamhlanje sikwethulela uhlelo lokuxwayisa ngodlame olubhekiswe kwabesifazane kanye nezingane. Ngomhlazi inhlanu kwephezulu ongane nokwelanga ube isimenyo esiqavile emcimbini wabenkolo yamaMuslim. Waqwashisa ngokuhlukunyezwa kwabesifazane kanye nezingane phecelezi i-gender based violence. Uzokhumbula ke mbukele ukuthi ke isilo kanye nendlunkulu sikhathazekile kakhulu ke malungana nokubulawa kwabantu besifazane kanye nezingane kuleli.
So ladies and gentlemen, it is always a great pleasure to me to be part of such services to the nation, especially by the religious community whom actually some have just seek the support from above. To seek the spirits of God to scatter all over this kingdom, not just in the kingdom as it is, but in South Africa at large. Why not the continent? Why not the world at large, which has been actually facing such a very problem of losing so many people through coronavirus. Besides what we're discussing here, sometimes God speaks to the people, but not by allowing the devil spirit to erupt or to have a crisis on earth. But God needs people to change their lifestyle. Not that he allows the people to do things that are wrong and hoping that they are going to seek and forgiveness from him after they know that they are going to carry on with their sins again. The coronavirus has made everybody to rethink how things should be done. But before I say anything to you, my ladies and my brothers and sisters, we need to understand that the problem of this gender violence that we are talking about, it's not starting today. It comes a long way. People think that, you know, when people are being harassed, they think it's just harassment. They put it nicely, but when it comes to abuse, it's making things to be very worse. We as Zulus used to give respect to our women. And we used to give our women position to lead. It's very confusing what is happening. I don't want to talk about things that used to happen during apartheid, because people, they are always criticizing than to correct themselves. But things were not the same as it is. We need to stand for the truth, because the love of truth is the spirit of men. If we want peace in our country, we need to understand how are we governing our country. If you isolate yourself saying that you are not a government, you are telling lies. We are part and parcel of the government of today. So, as much as I'm proud of my people who are Zulus and their heritage, I'm cognizant of the validity and importance of other racial groups in our province. A lot of people have been saying here, let's work together to stop this violence that is just making towards women and children. I've been talking about this for years, before it's like this. But people couldn't understand what I was talking about. It's just like the time, 1980, when God tells me about HIV and AIDS, and there's a disease coming, and people are saying that, oh, he's just thinking that he's a prophet. He's prophesizing. But when it came in 1994, it came to this province first, at Kwahlabisa. So now, if he wants to work together, if he wants to do things together, we need to put aside differences. But this is the differences that makes things to getting worse in our country. That's why we never take control. And then the devil spirits will just instinct each and everyone, each and everyone, each and everyone, each and everyone. So now, I'm saying this because I believe in Christ. That's how I believe. So, I believe and I understand and I respect the other believers who believe in their way. And I respect those people. That's why we need to look at how could we respect each other.
Mbukeli, inkulumo yesilokwe iyaqhubeka ngemuva kwekhefu. Alesiphinde sikubingelele sikwamukele mongabe usanda kusijoyina futhi mbukele ohlelweni lwakho oluyintandokazi ebukhosini. Namhlanje ke mbukele sikwethulela inkulumo yesile siyethule eqhubeka umcimbi wokuxwayisa ke ngokubulawa kwabantu besifazane kanye nezingane obubanjelwe ke kwelika banana ngabe nkolo yamaMuslim.
As I said earlier, in the past I always argue that South Africans should move from tolerating each other to accepting each other. Having said that, knowing very well that there are people that were born with them and we grew up together, but there are people that we're living with in our country whom we don't know how they left their country and come to our country, what problems they've created in their own countries. Because when people are talking about abusement, something that is strange and a stranger to us, the way how it is, maybe other people will say that, or now he's starting to talk about those people. But if we just go into the religious organizations, we'll see the problem. How many people who are stealing your money, taking it out of this country, who doesn't belong here? Who say they are praying for you? What abuse they are doing to your own children that are attending their own churches? I'm not against people going to any church, but it was such a mess. I don't believe to be prayed by anybody. I pray myself. If I've got sins that I've just created, I seek an apology from above. So now, having said that, I wish to emphasize the fact that there will be no acceptance without true understanding. We need to understand each other in South Africa first. If we have never been understanding each other, we'll never understand each other anymore. There were things of the past that have brought us all together. Apartheid has brought all those that were not accepted in apartheid system government together. Why now we say that we're in a democratic country and we're still talking about such nuisance things? Because all these things that are happening here to us, it's not supposed to happen to us. We're in a position to build this country in all spheres and to make everybody to walk free. Our girls can't just go even to their own neighbors. And we don't know our children, when they left their own families, going to schools, what is happening between the school and their family houses. And they are being attacked and they are being raped, children. I know sometimes the blame can be put to the government. It's not the government to stop violence within the people. It is the people within their own areas where they are that they must take arms and stop this nonsense. To prevent the problem altogether. Nungolele de mina bangwethu ngoba kuyathiwa amaZulu. Abanye babethi the Zulu man can't stop talking without lifting the name of Shaya. Thina ngesiko lethu umuntu wesilisa wayeqondiswa njengenduku. Ingane iqondiswa ngoswazi. Namhlanje akusenzeki lokho. Sekuthiwa sifundise iy'ngane zethu ukuthi kulalwa kanjani. Angizukuyalela, but this is not the day. But it has been always my position that the history of AmaZulu will never be complete without the history of the British, who are reciting in my kingdom, the French, who are reciting in my kingdom, the Indians, who are reciting in my kingdom, the Afrikaners, who are reciting in my kingdom, and others like us Zulus. I'm aware how much spiritual other groups are, and there is no doubt in my mind, ladies and gentlemen, that it is this collective spiritual that has kept us throughout many life's challenges. So now, even as a Christian, as I've said, I do have a deep understanding about this important spiritual life. As such, I always like to reflect on this aspect of life, which in my view nowadays is less understood by many people, especially in a world that is now considered secular. It is unfortunate that in many of our communities in South Africa today, spiritual matters seem to have taken a back seat, and yet they are a backbone of life. That's why I have such a respect of other religious groups with what they believed in. God wants love from one another to unite us.
Mbukeli, ake siphinde sibonane futhi ngemumva kwekhefu. Saphinda sangena sakulukudela futhi mbukeli njengoba namhlanje sikwethulela inkulumo yesile siyethule eqhubeka kumcimbi wokulwisana ke nokuhlunyezwa kwabantu besifazane kanye nezingane. Isile kwesiyiphethe kanje inkulumo yaso. Bayede hlanga lomhlabathi.
If we're talking in terms of helping each other and stopping all the problems that is facing us by ourselves, we need to do policing ourselves. No one must actually keep quiet. Mangizolezingane zabantu ekhuluma lapha kimi ngizobuhlungu. Abantu abahlupheka benabayini babo. Bashushwa ngabayini babo. Ney'ngane bazibabulala iy'ngane. I've been talking about this 2 days ago. What kind of a man that kills his wife and kills his children and cut the children into pieces and then he kills himself after that? And then I've told my people that those that are just committing suicide within them, they must know that they will never see the eyes of their ancestors. They will never see the eye of God. They will never. They must forget. Find my God. Now, this is in Dogs Kumaras and Zabetu. We need to help each other by working together. That is the only solution. So that's why I'm inviting you, my brother, and all other organizations that are here. All of you, I'm looking for your expertise. You can contribute a lot to this province. We can make this province a small Switzerland. As long as we can work together. If you need me, I'm there. But I need you because I want to see that this kingdom of KwaZulu-Natal is working peacefully together. We are one. If the wind blows from the sea, if some very strong cyclones comes into, it discriminates no one. Did you hear, have you heard what is happening in Madagascar? Forget not, Madagascar is part of Africa. It's been very bad in Malawi about 2 years ago. And Mozambique and then Zimbabwe. And how many hurricanes has been coming across yourselves? You've been looking at this from far away in South America, in North America. But now it's here. I feel very sorry that we've just actually had a problem of explosion in our oil refinery here in Durban yesterday. It's so painful. The pollution, when I was talking in terms of climate change, it affects us also. We are looking for rain. And it's a rainy season, and we need to produce food. The food parcel that has been going around from April to June up to now, where does this food come from? Something that is very eruptive to my heart is that if a person is not engaged to do something, who will think of something that is unacceptable all the time? Utshwala abaze bayisona emhlabeni. Buyibulele imizi. That's why there are so many drugs going around. So, Nani, please, siyacela ukuthi ni report, especially nina social development, social department. Because some other information, it's not easy to be found. So now, I'm with you. All of you, I belong to you. Let's work together. Tell the founder that we cannot do something without you. Any project. Ngiyazi ukuthi abafowethu base Middle East, the Middle Eastern people, they've got plenty of this. If they can help us in Mozambique, we can do much better things. So, the women of South Africa must rest assured that I'm on their side. I'm prepared to protect them till the last drop of my blood. So those who kill women are killing South Africa and continent of Africa at large. I own this war. And all those who regard themselves as good citizens should own it. So I'm looking forward to all of us collaborating to eliminate the scourge of gender-based violence. I wish you Merry Christmas and prosperous New Year, and I wish our women and honor them their respect, and then I wish our children to be safe. Thank you.
Mbukeli, ngake besikuphathele kona ohlelweni lanamhlanje, sihlangabeze futhi ngokuzayo.